Hi, I'm Mark from Sounds in Sync, the developer of EdiLoad. In this video, I'm going to show you what's new in EdiLoad version 6. Let's start by looking at the assembly window. Guide tracks can now be loaded into this window. EdiLoad uses these to align the waveforms of your location wave files. So when you export a PTX or AAF file, the clips are perfectly in sync. Markers are also exported, so the calculated offsets can be checked. In the assembly settings window, you can now select between Match by Edit Data, Match by File, and Match by Timecode. Match by Edit Data is what was available in EdiLoad version 5, while the two new match modes use a combination of the edit list data and loaded guide tracks to match each WAV file. The Match by File match mode allows you to use edit lists that do not contain valid source timecodes. The list must still contain WAV file names or scene intake information, but EdiLoad effectively calculates the source timecodes by comparing the guide track waveforms with each location WAV file to calculate an offset from start of file for each event. The Match by Timecode match mode allows you to use edit lists that do not contain any metadata that can link each event to a WAV file, or when the WAV files do not contain any field recorder metadata. The source timecodes in the edit list must be valid, and the timestamps in each WAV must have referenced time of day during the shoot. EdiLoad uses the source timecodes to find all WAVs recorded at that time of day, and then the guide track to select the correct location WAV file. All selections made in the settings window, the Export PTX window clip color settings, the location WAV parent folder location, and guide track locations can now all be stored in a single production settings slot. Name each slot with a production name or however you wish, and keyboard shortcuts provided for ease of recall. The status bar shows all the important assembly settings and allows you to update the values directly. The new Assembly Settings Export tab allows you to configure PTX or AAF exports to copy or split to mono all matched WAVs during export. Moving to the WAV file list window, additional settings have been added to ignore WAV files during import that are duplicate, are named a particular way, or are contained within particular folders. Once your WAVs are loaded, you can now copy or split these WAV files to mono. Settings are provided to rename the WAV files and set up the required folder structure of the new WAVs, from using the old folder structure to creating new child folders named with the metadata stored within each WAV. The new WAV files can have their field recorder metadata recreated to make sure the IXML and BEXT chunks are valid and match. This happens automatically for split WAVs and by selection for copies. Picture cut and scene change track PTX exports now provide the option to export markers. Select the marker color and marker track required. During Pro Tools reconforms, a PTX file containing reconform markers can be created using these settings. And loaded into Pro Tools once the reconform has completed. And lastly, EdiLoad PTX file exports that link to 32-bit WAV files now don't force Pro Tools to copy the media while opening the PTX file. So you can now create your 32-bit assemblies linked to the original location WAVs. See the EdiLoad user guide in the EdiLoad help menu for a full list of all the new features and fixes in EdiLoad version 6. There's also a video that runs through the assembly features in a lot more detail. To try EdiLoad for yourself, either on macOS or Windows, just head to the download page of the website. Once the app is installed, just run it and click Try to activate a trial license.